California Department of Fish and Wildlife support and maintain a Kokanee salmon population. These are inland species, so they don't run to the ocean. Our Kokanee salmon eggs that the hatchery grows up to become fingerlings are all taken from the Little Truckee River, which is right behind me. We do our operations here annually. So from about September to November, fish are coming upstream, and that's when we collect some of them and spawn them and take the eggs back to our hatcheries to grow them up and then plant them out throughout the state. Our spawn operations for Kokanee salmon are quite a large effort. We have the hatchery folks that we need to coordinate with. We have fisheries branch that will coordinate staff as well. And then we have the regional offices that also help out, and external volunteers help out as well. It involves setting up a weir so that we can collect the fish in the weir and then taking those fish and spawning them. So collecting the eggs and the milt from the females and males. The hatchery folks set up downriver, and the rest of us start upriver and corral all of the fish down to a smaller section. Makes it easier for us to get them in the nets, grab them with seine nets, and collect them and give them to the hatchery staff for processing. So once we collect the fish and the eggs and the milt are collected, they are fertilized on site immediately. And then they go through quite a rigorous process to make sure they're clean and safe. So we actually do an iodine bath. They are put into cheesecloth and suspended in water so that they're not squished. And then in coolers, we transport them to the hatcheries for unpacking and settling in so that they can grow up to be the fingerlings before they get sent out.
Kokanee are planted in a lot of lakes throughout California. There are several waters in the Sierras that receive them. Waters that are closer to the valley floor usually have a good cold water pool where they're able to survive the hot summers. Kokanee are a hugely popular sport fish. They're fast action fisheries in some of our waters. Targeting kokanee, you know, does take some specialized equipment. A lot of the people that are targeting from boats are using things like downriggers or some sort of method to get down in the water column. You're basically trying to get a reaction bite out of them using something that's loud and flashy and brightly colored. These are salmon species. They look like salmon, they eat like salmon, they taste like salmon. It's one of the closest things you could have to, you know, their seagoing cousins.